Mr. President, the bill that I'm introducing today aims to address one of the issues that has been faced in the City of Adelaide over a number of years, and that is the way in which rate exemptions are applied. And I should note, of course, that I am a City of Adelaide resident, so I have an interest in what occurs in the City of Adelaide, but this issue is much broader than simply the City of Adelaide. It extends, or the principle extends, to other council jurisdictions and, of course, is of interest to all South Australians who are facing an increase in their council rates at this time. Our skyline has witnessed significant transformations in recent years. Buildings such as the Festival Tower now loom over our Riverbank precinct. And while these buildings have been erected on parklands, they are not contributing their fair share to the people of Adelaide. This bill would empower the Adelaide City Council to levy rates on the area where the Hayjack Plaza used to be and where the Walker Corporation's Festival Tower is now under construction. Rate income is valuable to contribute to the upkeep and development of our city, and organisations such as corporations and casinos should not be exempt. Rates are the lifeblood of local government, enabling the provision of essential services, maintaining infrastructure and enhancing the quality of life for residents and businesses. While ratepayers across the state are seeing their rates rise due to the current economic crisis and high CPI, it's only fair that large corporations pay their fair share. Why is one of Australia's richest people, a multi-billionaire, being given a rate exemption, Mr. President? In 2020, the Advertiser reported on the Walker Corporation's rate status in an article titled "Walker Corp Building on Festival Plaza Could Become Test Case on Council Rate Exemptions." At that time, the article claimed that the Walker Corporation being exempt from rates was costing the City of Adelaide $150,000 in lost revenue each year. Given the increases in rates since that time, there is the potential for that revenue to be much higher. At that time, the Advertiser also reported that Sky City Adelaide was not paying any rates. However, we have been advised that that situation has been remedied, and I understand that Sky City is now paying rates to the City of Adelaide as the land title has been transferred. However, Mr. President, how was it that we had a casino being built on Crown land that was not paying any rates? How did that occur? This private member's bill will close that loophole, make it very clear that casinos should not be granted any rate exemption, and make it very clear that the Walker Corporation will not be granted any rate exemption. It's really important that we establish this principle, Mr. President, particularly if we're going to see a second tower blighting our city landscape, as I understand is under contemplation from the Malinowskis government. I must say what an outrageous deal this is that the Walker Corporation have been granted over our public space. There's a bucket load of taxpayer money that's being poured into that project, if media reports are to be believed. A huge amount of money, taxpayer money, that has been spent on that festival plaza. You've got a private corporation seizing our public land, which could have been returned to parklands, and to add insult to injury, they're not even paying rates. What an amazing deal for the Walker Corporation. What a dud deal for the people of South Australia. It's outrageous. And quite frankly, I find it disgusting that the Labor and Liberal parties could allow such a appalling exploitation of the people of South Australia and our public land to occur. It's a disgrace, an absolute disgrace. This bill seeks to remedy that. It's worth noting too, Mr. President, that the City of Adelaide does forfeit a significant amount of rates through exemptions. There was a workshop conducted back in November of 2021. The City of Adelaide, which was reported in the Advertiser. Now, whilst I was actually on the City Council at that time, I wasn't present at that workshop, I was away, but I have read the papers of the workshop, they're publicly available, and available to members of this place on the City of Adelaide website. 27.4% of rates income forfeited through exemptions and rebates, it's noted in that report. And the report claims that the impact of this is disproportionately allocated across the community. Well, 22.7% of rates income is forfeited through exemptions in Adelaide. It should be noted, Mr. President, this is very high when compared to the City of Melbourne, who only forfeit 12.2% of their rates through exemptions. And again, that's according to that report. The report goes on to include a map which highlights areas where rate exemptions apply. And I would encourage members of this place to have a look at that. While some of those areas where rates are not applied are council-owned buildings or recreational reserves, there are some that are businesses operating for private profit, like the Walker Corporation, and, as I understand previously, like the casino. By holding profit-making corporations accountable through rates, we can ensure that our community resources are equitably distributed, fostering a sustainable environment for all residents and businesses to thrive. The community requires shared responsibility, not a system where big business does not have to contribute to the running of the city or the maintenance of our public realm. And there's been an interesting debate occurring at the moment, Mr. President, around the state of our public streets and, in particular, around the state of North Terrace. Why shouldn't one of Australia's richest people have to contribute to maintenance of the public realm? Why should the Walker Corporation be given a free pass? So this bill is closing off that loophole, Mr. President. And with that, I conclude my remarks.